If I asked you to explain what makes a great luxury limousine, you'd probably list things like exceptional ride quality, plush leather seats, and the latest in-car technology, the cornerstones of modern automotive indulgence. But there's one more thing too, performance.
Let's face it, every single luxury car on sale today is, well, quick. Performance car troubling speed is a given, right? Well, that wasn't always the case. Luxury and performance didn't always go hand in hand. But actually, I reckon it was this thing that helped change that.
The Mercedes-Benz 450 SEL 6.9 was launched in 1975 as the top-of-the-line model in the 116 S-Class series. Naturally, this gave it an air of luxurious superiority that very few cars could hope to match, what with its optional leather seats, in addition to the standard velour, broad walnut dash, and get this, adjustable suspension.
Sitting in the back and being chauffeured around was also a common occurrence in the 6.9, what with all the space back here and useful amenities like this ashtray. I mean, it really is palatial. I feel like doing the rest of the video from the back seats. I am so comfortable.
Thing is, if you owned one of these things, it would be a shame to spend all of your time lounging around in the back seats because, well, let me show you.
Now, I'm sure you'll have noticed that this car has a rather large bonnet. It's huge, in fact. But then there's good reason for that, because underneath is a 6,834cc V8, which obviously Mercedes-Benz calls a 6.9, because, well, Mercedes-Benz. Either way, it makes 282 brake horsepower and 406 pound-foot of torque, which is enough for 0 to 62 miles an hour in 7.4 seconds, and a top speed of 140 miles an hour.
Now, of course, most of those numbers are nothing to write home about by modern standards. But bear in mind that in 1975, the Porsche 930 was producing a whole 153 pound-foot of torque less than the big Mercedes. Even a far more modern V10 E60 M5 BMW produces less torque than the 6.9. This was, without doubt, a seriously, seriously punchy car.
The engine itself is the same MA100 unit as was used in the Mercedes-Benz 600, or the Grosser as it was better known. Except for the 6.9, it's been bored out from 103 to 107 millimeters and apparently bench tested for over 4 hours, with 40 minutes of that under full load. And trust me, from where I'm sitting, it feels completely bulletproof. Never mind Chelsea tractors, this is a proper tank. Although I don't think your average tank would have an engine as creamy or smooth as this one. And even now, it does that thing that every good luxury car should do. It feels quick, but never rushed. I can put the 3-speed gearbox into sport mode, there's the downchange, but even then, there's never any rough edges to the power. It just surges forwards towards the horizon, drinking gallons and gallons of fuel as it goes. I really do feel like an absolute king driving this thing.
Thing is, putting a big engine in a luxury car is one thing. Making it handle all 1.9 tons of it in 1975, remember, was something else entirely. In order to address this, Mercedes gave the 6.9 an entirely new hydropneumatic self-leveling suspension setup. It worked using a pressurized oil system that kept the oil volume in the spring struts level so that the ride height would remain constant even under heavy cornering. And to top things off, stiffer anti-roll bars were fitted along with a limited slip differential.
The result was, well, profound. The June 1975 issue of Car magazine declared that the 6.9 is no disappointment in anything from a hairpin to a three-figure bend. The suspension soaks up bumps, the transmission is wonderfully smooth and easy to control, and the steering is servo-assisted in a way that highlights the nearly neutral responses
of the vehicle.
High praise indeed, but how does this translate into the modern day? Does it handle any better than a Carnival Cruise's superliner, for example?
Do you know what? Yes, it does. Sure, there's plenty of play in the steering and it's not what you'd call communicative. But for a car this size, this heavy, you can go around corners at some quite unruly speeds. I mean, no, it's not a patch on a modern AMG S-Class, say, but when you consider that it's almost 50 years old, it is pretty impressive. I think the only limiting factor are these velour upholstery seats, because not only are they quite sweaty on a hot day like today, they're also pretty slidey as well. I've not been held in place. I feel like an eel in an oil can, if I'm being perfectly honest with you.
However, there is one way in which it really does feel like a boat, and that is the comfort. It is so smooth in the cabin, so well isolated from any compressions, that it's like the 6.9 magically transforms your local bumpy A-road into the serene waters of Lake Geneva on a beautiful summer's day.
You can feel that hydropneumatic suspension working wonders and giving you the very best version of every road surface. At times it feels like the car is actually floating, elevating you above the uncouth potholes of the British road network. You know, I'm pretty sure I could drive this thing down a flight of stairs and honestly, it would barely register.
What I love about the 6.9 is that it didn't need to handle. It didn't need this engine with this power. It was already a 6.3 V8. It would have been fine. But then, fine doesn't quite cut it if you want true luxury. For that, you need excess. You need ostentation. You need damn near perfection. And that's exactly what this car is all about.
Remember, this car was launched straight after the 1973 oil crisis. At the height of it, you couldn't drive on a Sunday, and yet here was a 6.9-litre limousine that did 12 miles per gallon, was faster in a straight line than most sports cars, and cost the modern-day equivalent of almost 200,000 euros. That is luxury. Ever since, luxury cars have had a different benchmark. The AMG S-Class, Audi S8, Jaguar XJR, even SUVs like the Bentley Bentayga, the performance they offer has become central to the ultimate luxury package. The end result is that just because it's big and comfortable doesn't mean it can't be fast.